back to react to another Eurovision 2023 video, and this is the very long-awaited and highly anticipated song
Euphoria.
No, by LOREEN, but not Euphoria. She was well, very, very, very well known for Euphoria, and she decided to enter this year again.
Wow!
And she,
I'm so excited for this one.
Unsurprisingly. Won the whole thing.
Obviously, I mean,
so,
she's a queen.
So let's see what she came up with this time. I'm quite excited.
What's the name of the song?
This one is Tattoo.
Ooh.
So
let's see. I mean, I have no doubt it's gonna be incredible.
Amazing.
Let's see.
LOREEN the Queen.
Wow, what are we looking at exactly?
Wow, that's staging.
It's kind of claustrophobic, no? Look at those nails, oh my god. Oh my god.
Wow.
She looks like a warrior.
She looks like an avatar.
Like
an avatar.
Oh, we're escalating already. Oh my god. This part I really like. The part where it's like slowly escalating. And then. Yes! This part's good.
Look at her abs! Oh my god!
She's very captivating.
She is.
It's good. Wow.
Oh, wow.
I mean, she's a classic.
I mean, she is your like queen Eurovision.
Yeah.
Queen of Eurovision act. Like.
Actually, I missed her, like actually seeing her perform on stage and, you know, how those movements when she's on the ground and like just moving around with her arms kind of reminded me of her performance of Euphoria.
She's very unique.
She's very unique. I don't.
You do this, and you're like LOREEN.
Yeah. It kind of reminded me of. It took me back to
Euphoria.
To Euphoria, and I remember how good she was then, and I can't imagine how good she is now. Actually,
she the song is, I think, epic. Like as you were saying, the escalation onto the chorus is so like, oh, yes, it like
exactly.
It like. Bring something in me, bring something alive.
Yeah, exactly.
So this might be an unpopular opinion, but her vocals, in my opinion, are not the strongest.
Yeah.
And even in Euphoria, they weren't the strongest. But she makes up for it by her, the emotion she brings out through her voice. The emotion she brings her voice, but also like through her movements, which aren't like her dance
moves. I don't know if it's like a problem with her voice or it was a problem with her breathing sometimes.
Or like just she feels so much emotion that her voice
kind of cracks.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And to be fair, like I'm fine with that. Like I don't judge Loreen just on her voice. She has so much more to her act than that.
Mm-hmm.
And she, as you said, she drew me. I couldn't take my eyes off. Okay. She was so I try not to say this when I review songs, but she's such a Eurovision performer. It's like you can't judge people by saying Eurovision. But like she's just so what the Eurovision embodies. Like she's a great singer with so much emotion, like so much drama.
But okay, so I have a question for you.
Do you think the song is as good or anywhere close to Euphoria?
You know what? I think so. I think it's quite close. Like it was not as good as Euphoria. But I think it's quite close. You don't seem to think
so. I don't think it comes close to Euphoria, in my opinion.
Mm.
I love Loreen. I love her as a performer. I love everything she was doing on stage. But there was only one climax for me, which we heard this in the beginning, as soon as she started lifting like the stage or whatever she was lifting. And then it just came a bit later on in the song, but there wasn't like an extra, you know, climb. So I would say that Sweden did deliver with Loreen, but unfortunately the song, maybe with Loreen we expect more, you know what I mean?
Then again, I think Euphoria was just a song on its own, kind of in its own respect. This is a bit of a different song with different different techniques of escalation, if you know what I mean.
Uh-huh. But that's the problem with returning artists, you know?
Yes.
Like, whether you like it or not, people, individuals, you know, fans are gonna, like, compare you to your own song. Everyone's gonna be comparing it to Euphoria, whether we like it or not.
Whether we like it or not, yes.
So people are gonna say, but is it really as good as Euphoria? Is it, like, does it match? Is it even better? That's what's gonna happen with the song. That's what I think will happen.
I know, and therefore it can't be judged in as a song in its own right.
Yeah, unfortunately.
I do like it though.
I think probably having had Loreen not won the Eurovision before, and you know this is her first ever entry in the Eurovision, she would probably easily win it, in my opinion.
I mean, I can see people becoming obsessed with this song though. She's such a unique artist,
mm-hmm.
that I don't think people can get tired of her, to be honest. As in, she'll still feel raw and new as she did it the first time. And I think the song, I don't know, it just builds. I liked that about it, and I liked the ooh, 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 and all the it's a good song for me. Maybe I'm so tired of hearing Euphoria that the magic of Euphoria has kind of, it's a bit like, okay, Euphoria, again. But this is, I like this new sound.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I don't know. You're making me doubt myself now.
but it stands to reason, no? That you're going to everyone's going to end up comparing her to, you know, Loreen of the past, or not Loreen of the past, as in just,
I mean, Loreen of
the Euphoria.
Loreen of the present looks stunning. <She's even better. laughs> Oh my god.
She did not age a day.
Oh my goodness. How old secrets. Is Loreen? Just out of curiosity, how old do you think she is?
I would say like 35.
35, okay, wait. 39. She's 39.
39 year old.
Yeah. 39,
wow,
she looks and looks amazing. Like that. She's Louise.
Beautiful.
Louise. I mean, she looks great. And she did great there. I think it's a solid Eurovision entry.
It is. No, it's a, I love that.
Top
it's
five
Eurovision
fighting.
This year. Probably. Yeah.
Top five.
I agree.
Okay.
Let's rate it.
Hmm. Okay, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Wait, no.
3 hours later.
Okay. All right. Okay. On three.
three. Let's go.
One, two, three, nine.
7.5 is a really good mark. I'm telling you, okay? It's like a B in an exam.
Are you joking? Did you not witness the Loreen?
Yes, I did.
7.5. I mean, it's your opinion, whatever. But 7.5. Hi, the sun just decided to go away all of a sudden and there's loads of clouds everywhere, so sorry for the change in lighting.
Yeah,
we were saying...
back to that.
Okay, you gave it a 7.5.
Yeah.
I understand it didn't reach as big a climax.
So I'm one of those fans that I think most fans will end up being. Comparing Loreen to her old song,
Euphoria,
unfortunately. I had massively high expectations for her. That's what struck me the most.
And you don't feel like she reached those expectations? So she was as expressive and as...
She was, but not as much as I thought she would.
Okay, so think of it as a song. Mm-hmm. As a song. On its own.
So if I were to just think of Loreen as, you know, just a new singer.
Yes,
exactly. No, I would probably rate her a bit higher. That's true. So I would probably
to compare her.
Yeah.
So think of it.
No, I know, it's not fair.
Think of it.
But people will. Look, I'm going to re-rate it, okay? I'm going to give it an 8.
Since you allowed me to do that one time.
One time.
One. I think it was
most times.
Time. Oh, wait. No.
I'm gonna give it an 8. It's a good song.
It's a good
song. She's a massively amazing performer. I love her. Euphoria.
No, tattoo. This is the new Loreen era of tattoo.
Tattoo. I'm not sure it will win though.
I'm not sure it will win. Me neither.
Are we happy with
that?
I'm happy. I'm happy with my 8.
And I'm happy.
You're happy
with
nine. Your 9.
Yes.
Thank you for watching, guys. That was our reaction to the Swedish song. Stay tuned for more videos coming your end.
Bye. Ciao. No,